Get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from MASH, Loretta Swicks, Snowy Mitchell, and Fanny Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rivers!
Thank you for coming here today. Now, would you join me in greeting our stars? Hello, stars.
Hello, dear.
No answer. I guess there are no stars on the stage.
Toscanini said the stars are in heaven, and on earth we are only artists, good and bad. Now, if you can get...
If you can get this
show started after that dull remark, let me know. I'll be here.
I think it was touching and beautiful. Only stars in heaven. Isn't that wonderful? I think I'll go off and meditate on that for a while. Go to heaven. Would you greet our two players here, Barbara Fain and Luann Odenino? Our current champ is Barbara here with $350. And now she's being challenged by Luann Odenino, who had her first round question and did not match any of our stars. And we'll see how Barbara does right now with her first round question, which reads as follows. Bob likes to date really young girls. Yeah. So instead of flowers, he usually takes along blank as a gift. All right, Barbara. Bob likes to date really young girls, so instead of flowers, he usually takes a long blank as a gift.
A rattle.
A rattle. That's young, isn't it? Talk about robbing the cradle. Okay, David, she said a rattle.
We were right along, that we were in the same groove there. Now, this could pass because it sometimes does have a noise-making thing on it.
Oh,
it's a teething ring.
A teething ring. That is really young. Okay.
Well.
Yes.
Well, he's going to laugh, giggle, and be wrong through another week.
That's why we keep asking him back.
I don't know what this is. I was just sitting here and writing.
A box of lollipops.
Perk down.
Yeah. Perk down.
It's going to be a long night, this thing. So, disposable diapers.
Disposable diapers.
It's a wonderful answer.
Well, Barbara, we haven't had any rattles so far. Let's see if we get one from Loretta. Hmm?
I was thinking along the lines of Brett. Candy bars.
Candy bars. Yes, that's reminiscent of Artie Johnson. Remember, he used to approach the little girls, ask them if they wanted a... Would you like a little walnut, old little girl there?
Would you?
Bob likes it. Oh, yes, of course.
Thank you very much.
Naturally. This guy likes to date young girls, so instead of flowers, he takes a long blank as a gift.
Well, I was thinking along the lines of Charles Nelson Reilly. It's going to be a long night. A pacifier.
A pacifier. A pacifier.
That's good.
Okay, yes, indeed it is. Now we come to Miss Fanny, honey.
Yes, I said a Barbie doll.
A Barbie doll. Candy. So there we are at the end of round one, and neither of our players here has scored, but we'll see what happens in round two after this. Here we go. Bing. Round two. Luann, final round. You may have A or B.
B, please.
B it is for you. B says, at the buffet restaurant, the manager said to Marvin, when we said you could have anything you want for $5.95, we didn't mean you could have the blank. When we said you could have anything you want for $5.95, we didn't mean you could have the blank.
Yeah.
There he goes again.
Love it. Just love it.
Love it. He's going to be wrong. He's going to be
great. Okay, Luann. At the buffet restaurant, the manager said to Marvin, "Well, we said you could have anything you want for $5.95. We didn't mean you could have the blank."
The table?
You do have bus fare home. Okay, the man.
Back of the bus.
It's not the back of the bus.
He didn't mean the back of the bus. He's a back in the bus. Okay. Now we're ready to see
yours. You gotta be careful. I said the hostess.
Very good. Now you got the idea, right, Luann? All right.
Did you like that answer, honey?
I went pretty good.
I thought it was an excellent one. That was not a loser.
No, it's not a loser. I said the owner's daughter.
Well, what'd you say, Chuck?
Chuck said, "Don't you walk over here anymore?" I suppose you'll be phoning in from the cake next season. Blanche the waitress.
Very good answer.
But it wasn't worth walking over for.
Oh, yes, no, I'd walk over for Blanche the waitress.
He'd walk over for anything on two legs.
No?
That's right. Any waitress.
Any waitress. Thank you. You know me, don't you? All right. There you go. What do you got there?
Isn't this the second round?
There's a second and final round.
Why don't we just go to the tiebreaker?
No. Barbara has to have a shot at it first.
The cash register.
Cash register. Kind of imaginative answers here, but so far no match there.
Yes, sir.
Table.
She walked over and said, "Can I help you?" And he said, "Uh-huh."
So, now, Barbara, again, you're in the catbird seat. All you need to do is match one to win your second game. The Hollywood agent said, "I've got the world's most talented canary. Not only does he sing, he blanks." World's most talented canary. Not only does he sing, he blanks.
You know what Toscanini once said to a very heavily endowed soprano like
this? No, Mr. Riley. Tell us what Toscanini said.
You wonder why he doesn't walk over.
No, wait, just
he just looked at her and said, "If those were only brains." See, some Toscanini stories do work.
Okay, Barbara. The Hollywood agent said, "I've got the world's most talented canary. Not only does he sing, he blanks."
He dances.
What else? Song and dance canary. All we need is one song and dance canary, and Barbara will have won her second game.
Tap dances?
To bid this pretty lady adieu. It was a pleasure to meet you, Luann, and we'll send some gifts your way for Match Game 79.
Thanks,
Luann Odonino, ladies and gentlemen. Here you go again. You know how this goes. I'll touch over it lightly here. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, Barbara, and said, "Write down your best answer to this. I'm in blank." Remember, if you match the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And then for matching the third, $100. Three of the six stars will give you some assistance.
Loretta?
I'm in the money.
I'm in the money. Yes. Great old song.
Charles?
I'm in the mood for love.
Yeah. I'm in the mood for love.
Where I am when I'm not near Charles. Heaven. I'm in heaven.
I'm in heaven.
So I'm not even going to be up there.
I thought she was going to say I'm in heat.
So there you have, I'm in heaven. I'm in the mood for love, and I'm in the money. You want one of those?
I'm in heaven.
Well, I should pick money, but I feel good with in the mood for love. Mm-hmm.
You feel good for in the mood for love, Miss Charles.
Simply because
I'm near. All right, let's find out if it's up there. I'm in the mood for love. Charles' answer. May we see the $100 number? I'm in the money.
I'm in the money.
Loretta's answer. No. Now let's see the $250 number. I'm in the mood. There it is. Well, that surprised me. I thought that might be left there a little higher. What do you think's on top,
heaven.
Audience?
Heaven.
Trouble. Heaven. Okay, slide it, Ari. Oh, I'm in love. Period.
That's it.
Okay, we'll play the rest of the game in a moment or so, but right now we want to pause. We're going to do a little business with America, Barbara, okay? Okay, Barbara, you won $250. Means at least you'll play for us 10 times at about, or $2,500. Unless you have a lucky spin of the star wheel here, you will double your money if you get a lucky spin and play for $5,000. Good luck and have a go at it. All right. Get a double. Must out in this gold star area. I think he got it. That's called a near miss. All right, Barbara, good luck to you playing.
Courage, darling, courage.
David Doyle is all ready, and if you are, here it is.
All ready to fail.
Stop that.
Cool it. I'll see you blank. I'll see you blank. Okay, David's finished. Now, Barbara, if you give us the answer that he's written on the card, we give you $2,500. I'll see you...
in September.
In September.
Now, may I ask what that means, please? I'll see you in September.
That's an old song.
Oh, it is?
What is, how's it go?
Could you sing a little of it for
me? I can't do for you.
Really? Does anybody know that song? I'll see you... One person sing it. Stand up and sing that song. You. You know it, sir? You in the first row. The guy with a leather jacket. You started to stand up. Do you know it? Well, do you know it? The lady back there. Would you stand up?
I'll see you.
Never mind. Never mind. Give her a little something for her kind efforts, John, will you? Thank you very much, sir. Well, David, she says, I'll see you in September. We'll match you for
$2,500. I went to a song, I'll see you in my dreams.
That's it. Yes. I'll see you in my dreams. A very popular song there. Okay, Barbara, you're up to $700. You're going to meet another player now, so let's welcome Denise Gallardo. Nice to have you with us. We'd like to find out a little bit about you before we begin. You want to tell us where you're from and what you do with your life and all that?
I'm a California girl. I graduated from Stanford University a little over a year ago with a degree in design, which I've temporarily shelved, and now I'm doing the showbiz route. I'm a dancer, and I'm studying acting, and I'm working right now at the Playboy Club in L.A.
Uh-huh. What was your major in school? I didn't understand that.
Design.
Oh, a design major. Like costume design? Or?
Graphic design.
Graphic design. That's an interesting
field. Oh, my favorite kind of design.
Yes, of course. Yeah. Well, it's nice to meet a graphic designer aspiring actress. Good luck to you. Here we go. You can have A or B.
I'll take A.
You want A? All right. A it is for Denise. One Washington, D.C. tourist said to another, President Carter is getting strange. Take a look. There's blank growing on the White House lawn. Uh-oh, what's it say there?
Say it where?
In Variety.
Pop singles.
Oh, really?
Out of 1,732 songs, 1,731 places I'll see you in September.
Oh, I see.
I suppose you want to know what's in 1,732 place?
Yeah, what?
I'll see you in August, which they say is even a worse song.
Where's our ad in there?
This is last week, isn't it?
A year ago. No wonder. Did you write an answer, Charles?
Huh?
Did you write an answer?
In my Variety, I got to write to?
Yes.
What does it say?
Oh, my goodness.
You should know
better. I was so intent on landing my joke.
One Washington.
What, Toscanini wasn't tall at all.
No, he wasn't. He was about right up to here, Toscanini, yes. I'll tell you, I'll tell you.
No later.
One Washington, D.C. tourist said to another, President Carter
is getting... Oh, I got that one. Why don't you tell me it was that one?
Hold on, I see.
Get him out.
He's hot today.
Yeah. Are you ready for this?
Ready.
Okay. As President Carter's getting strange, take a look. There's blank growing on the White House lawn.
Peanuts.
Yeah. What? If you aspire to the theater, my dear, you must learn to project a little more and enunciate a little more clearly so I can hear you. Remember, I'm a middle-aged man, aging and deafing. Yes.
And other things.
That's right. That's right.
What?
My answer is peanuts.
Peanuts. Okay.
I didn't know Scully was going to sit down there. I thought he was going to sit up here.
I miss you, too.
I miss you, too, sweetheart. It's there are peanuts.
Okay.
Why don't you two do Othello in the park? Peanuts.
Peanuts. Desdemona, eh? Look, as President Carter's getting strange, take a look. There's blank growing on the White House lawn.
Peanuts.
If Brett and I did Othello, she would be Desdemona.
Desdemona. Not Desdemona. Okay, show.
I said grass.
Grass. Yes, sir, that'll be the day, won't it?
Yeah, that'd be nice if we balanced the budget.
Turnip green.
Well, because you see, in soul food, they have
ask
turnip
Scully,
greens
and.
Yeah, look who's telling us about soul food.
About soul food.
Well, haven't you ever been down to the West Boondocks restaurant on 10th Street in New York?
Yeah.
The first soul food restaurant I ever been. It was a wonderful place. Oh, wonderful. Do a little commercial here. Denise has four. You got one more chance to have a go at it here after this.
Show on our star, Gene River.
Okay, Johnny O. Thank you. All right, Barbara. You need four to tie and five to win. Tim said, it's tough having an interior decorator for a mother. When I was born, she wanted to return me because it didn't match the blank.
Stop having an interior decorator for a brother.
Oh, round one, I beg your pardon. Yeah. It's tough having an interior decorator for a mother. When I was born, she wanted to return me because I didn't match the blank.
I got it on.
The blank.
The blank.
Now they can read it.
Sure.
All right. Barbara, Tim said it's tough having an interior decorator for a mother. When I was born, she wanted to return me because I didn't match the blank.
The decor of the room?
The decor of the room. You're touching all bases there, huh? Okay, she said the decor of the room.
Yes, well, decor would be understood in this answer, I would imagine.
Bing, it does, indeed. The room. One for her, you.
One what?
She matched one.
Oh, that's right, exactly, of course, room.
That's two for her.
You know when you had that little picture taken when you, no clothes on?
Yes.
The rug, didn't match the rug.
Uh-huh.
Toscanini had no rugs in his home at all.
No. That would be a fur rug. Babies are usually posed naked on fur rugs. Remember?
No.
I have a picture of you.
Oh. Yeah.
Naked on a fur rug.
From last week.
I didn't want to say, Scully.
And you promised you wouldn't.
Yes.
Is it okay if I name the room?
Sure.
The nursery.
The nursery. Here we go.
I said the operating room walls.
The operating room walls?
Well, see, most operating rooms are white.
Yes.
Very good. Excellent joke.
The Toscanini joke.
Hang in there, Scully. Now we come to Fanny. Here it is. When I was born, she wanted to return me because I didn't match the...
the man she was married to at the time.
I got it. So now, in round one, it's 4-3 in favor of Denise, and round two will follow after that. Okay, here we go. Join us next time for Match Game 79. Gene Rayburn here. Thank you all. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 79. Hamark Goodson, Bill Todman. Turn it. The program has been edited for broadcast. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.